Hello everyone, and welcome to the Speculative Wildlife Research Center, where we reimagine creatures and monsters from all realms of fiction through the lens of speculative biology, the genre of science fiction that applies scientific principles and knowledge about biology, ecology, and evolution to creature design and world building. Today, we will be looking at Yoshi, the egg-throwing, high-jumping dinosaur from the Super Mario series, and imagine what such a creature would be like as a living, breathing animal. We will not be considering the individual character of Yoshi, but the entire species it forms a part of, as any significant adaptations resulting from evolution and natural selection would be widespread among the species, rather than specific to an individual. So, without further ado, let's get started. Yoshi, aka Yoshisaurus insularis, are a species of late surviving theropod dinosaur that originate from the island named after them, but in modern times they have been transported all around the world. Like many island-dwelling organisms, Yoshi are smaller in size than many continental relatives, both living and extinct. They stand out, however, due to two distinguishing traits. The first of which is their long, sticky tongue, which is equipped with accelerator and retractor muscles, not unlike that of a chameleon, and likewise used to capture prey. The Yoshi's second distinguishing trait is their powerful hind limbs, which allow them to leap incredible distances and run at great speeds through any kind of terrain. In order for these legs to be as powerful as they are, they are aided by the presence of huge anchoring muscles that form a thigh hump on its back. When they need to leap particularly far, Yoshi can aid themselves by kicking at the peak of their leap and extending small yet effective arm membranes in order to turn their jump into a very small glide and gain distance. Their powerful legs allow them even to swim through bodies of water. However, they prefer to avoid water as they are less capable of defending themselves from predators when submerged, and certain coastal subspecies refuse to approach water altogether due to the much higher presence of predators. Their remarkable speed and versatility has led to many attempts to domesticate them to be used as transport, aided by the use of specialized footwear to prevent injuries and claw wear. Although the use of Yoshi is not extensive, they are smart and loyal creatures and respond very well to training, forming strong bonds with their trainers. Many find their wide vocal range, which in the wild helps them communicate with one another, to be quite endearing. Yoshi, while preferring fruit as a source of food, are extreme omnivores, to the point that any creature smaller than them will almost immediately be considered as a potential meal. They have adapted incredibly well to this omnivory through a series of mechanisms that allow them to process food. For instance, their stomachs have special glands that produce a huge amount of collagen-rich mucus, which envelops all the indigestible remains of their meals. Since armored and spiny creatures are usually found in the Yoshi's ecosystem, Yoshi have evolved this mucus to stop undigested material from damaging their digestive system, thus turning such unappetizing creatures into a source of protein. These remains are coated in collagen until they form a safe pellet which is expelled from the body, the end result looking remarkably like Yoshi eggs. This similarity is not coincidental, as the storing of inedible pellets in Yoshi nests helps disguise the eggs, thus protecting them from predators. After all, any predator unlucky enough to try to feed on a Yoshi pellet will quickly stop considering Yoshi eggs as a source of food. Hard or sharp parts of their food, however, are not the only potential threat to the Yoshi. Creatures all around the world are known to develop chemical defenses, including poison, to avoid being eaten. Yoshi, in response, have evolved mechanisms that allow them to deal with dangerous or non-edible compounds present in their food. The simplest of these mechanisms, as well as the fastest, is puking. If the taste of whatever it is Yoshi have fed on is not to their liking, they can throw up immediately in order to avoid being hurt by potentially harmful substances. Compounds that are not immediately dangerous, but cannot be digested or captured in pellets, can be stored in the stomach to be vomited afterwards. Particularly entrepreneuring or unlucky Yoshi have even been witnessed throwing up bioluminescent substances, corrosive acid, or even boiling or burning liquid. Other compounds can simply be metabolized and added to the pigments of the Yoshi's scales, changing their color according to the dinosaur's diet. While green is the most common and, in some subspecies, the standard coloration, Yoshi can be seen in the wild in a huge variety of colors, from red and yellow to black and white. While this diversity is beautiful to look at, this makes distinguishing Yoshi subspecies a very hard task, sometimes being possible only through more subtle anatomical details, such as scale arrangement or external ornaments. Interestingly, these pigments can also end up coloring the eggs and the digestive pellets of the Yoshi, further muddying up the identity of the real eggs. Not everything a Yoshi is bound to find, however, can be treated as food. Their natural habitat has as many predators as it does prey, and Yoshi can also become prey if they are not careful. When Yoshi need to confront predators, which happens quite often, they can use the claws from both fore and hind limbs as weapons. While their limbs are not particularly well adapted to be used as weapons, their claws are sharp enough to deter most predators. Thanks to their powerful legs, Yoshi can also take to the air in an instant and, without a warning, fall heavily on top of potential predators, greatly damaging them in the process. If necessary, Yoshi can use their undigested pellets as a weapon, throwing them at predators. This behavior is, however, mostly favored by Yoshi that are not nesting eggs, but can be used even by nesting Yoshi as a last resort in order to secure the survival of the next generation, as well as their own. Despite the superficial similarity, Yoshi can easily distinguish pellets from real eggs and will never throw one of their own eggs, resorting instead to gently carrying them in their mouth if they need to escape the nest. And that's it for a speculative biology look into Yoshi. I hope you all enjoyed this channel's first video. I, for one, liked how this turned out. It was really fun to think about how all of Yoshi's quirky behaviors and attacks can be adjusted to be part of an ecologically sound organism, and I hope you liked the end result. Thank you all for watching, and see you next time on the Speculative Wildlife Research Center.